a sash of light in blue fog, a slow blinking of two red lanterns in river mist, or a deep smoke winding one hump of a mountain, and the smoke becomes a smoke known to your own twisted individual garments. The winding of it gets into your walk, into your hands, into your face, into your eyes. There's much to hold on to, and much to let go of, in love and in marriage. The trick really is the journey, and letting yourself experience it all as a gift. There's one piece about love and marriage that Sandberg doesn't say much about, in my estimation, but it's vitally important. The piece is this: we do not really love or experience the great gifts of love, we don't experience those in a vacuum. The greatest gifts of a loving relationship flourish when they are shared. Family, friends, colleagues, the community in which you live, the creator and spirit of life, these will all help as you try to love each other and as you love or close to them. Now I know just in our brief conversations, Nicholas, that you feel a bit like an introvert. And I am not suggesting that you become a socialite. But what I am saying is that you and Sarah are not alone as you create your new family together. Nor does your loving each other mean you will stop loving so many others. So as you pledge your lives to each other today, remember all of these people who are your witnesses, human and divine, and that they go with you. I have questions to ask the two of you. Sarah and Nicholas, in each other's presence, you have found a home, a sanctuary where love is offered and trust is given and received. I invite you now to declare your intentions as you continue in your commitment to one another. Sarah, you have chosen Nicholas to be your life partner, your husband. Will you love and respect him? Will you be honest with him always? Will you stand by him to whatever may come? So please respond that way. And then this. You have chosen Sarah to be your life partner, your wife. Will you love and respect her? Will you be honest with her always? Will you stand by her to whatever may come? So please respond that way.
I will.
Having journeyed with Nicholas and Sarah on their separate paths and come to witness as the past merge, will you, the parents of Sarah and Nicholas, please stand? You have given your love to them. You have shown them what love is like. You have shown them what building a home, a family is like. You have shown them what bonds between people are like. Now, as they freely give themselves to each other in marriage, will you continue to offer your love and support as they seek to create their new home and their new family? If so, please respond.
We will.
We will. Thank you. Please. Sir, your flowers.
Deeply when you speak.
I will listen to you. roots grow deeper as we learn and adapt together.
Letting our roots grow deeper as we learn and adapt together.
This day forward,
from this day forward,
I promise to love you just as you are.
I promise to love you just as you are.
Completely. I, Nicholas, take you, Sarah.
I, Nicholas, take you, Sarah.
Be my wife, my constant friend, and faithful partner.
Be my wife, my constant friend, and faithful partner.
I promise to stand beside you.
I promise to stand beside you.
Through the adventure.
The adventure and chaos of life.
To trust, honor, and respect you.
To trust, honor, and respect you.
To encourage and comfort you.
To encourage and comfort you.
And support you in your goals. I will celebrate life's joys with you.
I will celebrate life's joys with you.
And help you carry its grief.
And help you carry its grief.
I will listen deeply when you speak.
I will listen deeply when you speak.
I will forgive and strengthen you.
I will forgive and strengthen you.
And share honestly with you my hopes, fears, and dreams.
And share honestly with you my hopes, fears, and dreams.
I will continue to nurture and cultivate our relationship.
Letting our roots grow deeper
as we learn and adapt together.
As we learn and adapt together. From this day forward,
I promise to love you just as you are.
I promise to love you just as you are.
Completely and forever.
Completely.
Let us pray. Gracious God, we ask you to bless these symbols of love, this precious metal, this circle that encircles people's hearts and fingers. Bless these rings this day, as Sarah and Nicholas give them to each other, that they may be a constant reminder of the love that they have pledged to each other. And Sarah and Nicholas, chosen a bit of a symbolic act, a bit of a sand ceremony. It's a time when sands are blended together. It's a symbol of lives coming together, how they are blended together to make something unique and beautiful. This time I would invite Sarah to join in the sand ceremony.
Thank you.
Sarah, since you have promised your love to each other before God and these witnesses who have exchanged these solemn vows and symbols of abiding love, it is with great joy that I now pronounce you husband and wife. Mr. and Mrs. Nicholas and Sarah Avery.